And then as we started talking more infrastructure and what we're going to be doing, he laid out the game plan more or less. This is what we're going to do this week, this is what we're going to do the second week, on through the whole camp. And I really like that, you know, because we had a plan. He also played really, really well with my other coach, Paulino Hernandez. They got together and they made a game plan, you know. Capetillo wanted to restructure a lot of things, you know, because my stance, my movement in MMA is different. How we hold our stance is different, how we hold our ground. We're blocking kicks, takedowns, flying leg locks, all types of things. So it's a different sense how we generate the power. I'm doing boxing now, so we took it from the ground up and worked it, you know, on a complete different level, and we're still working at it. It hasn't been easy, but it's been a blessing, you know. It's good work. It's work that I welcome, you know, and day by day, I feel getting better. And right as he said, like, hey, right around this week is when you start feeling this, and right around this week, you start, you know, getting the hang of that, and it's, everything's been a point that he's laid out for me, so we're very happy. You know, we take it from the bag to the spawn, and now, June 1st to the actual fight, that's where the actual test comes.
You're obviously Cuban, but you don't fight Cuban style. They move a lot, they don't like to engage too much. Good defense, respect them, but you're very entertaining. Why not fight Cuban style? That's your background.
Well, in MMA, you know, you could get away with it, but it's different. You're kicking, you're punching. When you're kicking a lot, it's hard to hold that much movement because guys are just going to chop your leg if you're moving that much. So it's a little different. But the Cuban blood is in me, so don't be surprised if I get out there and I just make Nate look like a fool just with my movement. You know, I love to fight. My favorite fighter, as you said, Roberto Durante, somebody that I idolize a lot. So since I got to his gym, I told him, and he said, okay, I'm going to show you what made him so special. And there's a lot of attributes that I have that, you know, more or less, I could take a lot of his style and bring it into mine.
Who are some of your favorite boxers today that are active? Who do you love watching?
Terrence Crawford, obviously, you know, because he's undefeated and he puts it all on the line every time. He's willing to get knocked out or knock somebody dead, and that's something that I would respect. Obviously, Canelo, the Mexican monster, is one of my current favorites. I love watching this guy, man. He represents all of us Latin people really well. He just fucking puts it all on the line. There's just a lot of guys.
Gervonta Davis. What do you think about Tank?
Tank is a beast. He's just so athletic and gifted. And I like mean guys. I just don't like somebody that's a good athlete. I like somebody that's a good athlete.
Benavidez.
I can mean Benavidez. He's just a proper Mexican monster, you know. There's a bunch of guys. Vasily Lomachenko is one of my all-time favorites as well. Tyson Fury.
That's his favorite and his favorite.
And yours too, Ellie.
I'm not a fan of Fury.
And now he's fighting another hell of a
Usyk,
fighter. Usyk, which is a complete beast. He's like a fucking computer, this guy. I'm a huge fan of Usyk. Bigger fan of Tyson Fury. Who else we got that I was talking about the other day?
Chavez Sr., Chavez Jr.
Oh, Chavez Sr., yeah. Come on, you said current, man.
Okay, that's true, that's true. Okay. So if you never got an MMA and you would have stuck with boxing, would you be one of those names that you just mentioned? Would you be one of the best of the best if you just did boxing?
You know, I never liked to, you know, say if I would have had good grades and I would have stayed in the wrestling program or became a wrestler or if I, you know, but I'll tell you this much. I would have given my heart and soul. If MMA was around, it would have been boxing for me. And I would have just given my heart and soul. And I had a lot of natural attributes, hand speed, great chin, and my power developed as I got better in the sport with good technique, you know, so I definitely feel I could have made some strides in boxing, but would I have been this or that? I don't know, you know.
Okay, I got to ask you a serious question. Do you have Donald Trump's number on your phone?
Yeah.
Can we call him really quick? Because Ryan Garcia tweeted that Donald's walking him out, and I don't know if I believe Ryan on this one.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna call BS that Trump is walking him out. And could I call Donald Trump right now? Yes, I could. Would I know? Because this man is going to war for all of us. He's fighting a much bigger fight than I'll ever fight in my life. I'm just getting into a ring with some fucking guy that smokes weed and has fucking CTE. Donald Trump is actually going to war for all of us while this witch hunt is going on. So I wouldn't dare disturb his peace or anything just to call him and be like, yo, Trump is, you know?
Oh.
Whenever he messages me, I message him back right away.
What does he tell you?
You know, for the last fight with Nate Diaz, I'm now with Nate in Miami. He told me, hey, I'm going to be there, blah, blah, blah. When you're training, you're unstoppable, man. I hope your training is actually there with me, but like FaceTime. So,
we got a video. We might send it to you.
Yeah, we'll send you the video if you want. But yeah, Trump is just an amazing guy, someone that I look up to, and I can't believe he even knows my name and that I exist, you know. So it's something very surreal to me.
Fans love Nate, they love you. Does it surprise you how much love you get?
No, it doesn't. Like it always humbles me how much love I get, but at the same time, I know why they love me, because I'm just like them, man. I don't fall many times, and I get up, and I keep coming as hard as I can. There's no quitting me. I've never quit in a fight. I've never been broken in a fight. I've never given up in a fight. I might have lost. I might have had a bad strategy, a bad night, but I always come giving my all, and that's what my fans really appreciate, that I'm just like them, man. Somebody has been knocked down but gets up and keeps fighting.
You were in Vegas, New York, Miami, now LA. What do fans tell you when you go places? You're going through the airport, or you're eating somewhere. Fans come up to you. What do they say?
Depends. A lot of them are like, yo, man, kill this fool. I can't stand his ass. Some fans is like, bro, you're the fucking greatest thing ever. I love you. I've been watching you since the Kimbo Slice days. That's probably the number one thing they tell me. They come up and go, man, I've been watching you since the Kimbo Slice days. That's number one. Number two is kill this fool, man. I fucking can't stand this motherfucker. Kill him. Game bread. And a lot of people just come up, shake my hand, be like, hey, I don't want a picture in there. I just want to say I respect everything that you stand for and you speak up and your relationship with God and how you stand up for this country, you know, and how you stand up for Latinos. So that's probably the number three or fourth thing that I get told a lot, you know.
You never got a chance to fight Conor, correct?
No.
Would you love to fight him?
Would I love to fight him? Yeah, man, because it'd be a huge paycheck fighting against a fucking bum, you know, a guy that's a cokehead, you know, doesn't take the sport seriously. Guy that, you know, he made his money in his market and then he walked away from it and he's like pussyfooting if he's in or out. I'd love to get that guy and snap his fucking jaw, man.
Does he beat Chandler?
Probably beat Chandler.
Yeah, I think so. Who else would you love to fight if you could line up three fights for yourself?
Man, I got some big names in there that we're working on, definitely. You know, I like Logan Paul, man. I like what he did in the Mayweather fight. He came out to fight. He hurt him a couple times. He almost had him out at one point. And he's another huge draw. I'm a fucking huge draw. Me and that guy would just break box office records left and right. And then from there, you know, I'd have way more time with this guy. So I would want to face a boxer. You know, somebody that made their living boxing, you know, because I've made my living in MMA. We got some similar things, but it's not the same. The more I do boxing, I find that it's not the same. You know, fighting boxing is not the same. So the more time that I can get under my wings to prepare for these boxers, it's perfect. You know, I definitely want to rock and roll Nate's fucking brain, take him out of the picture, and then make it like a Logan Paul and just fucking break all types of box office records. And then after that, we'll see what the playing field looks like and get after it.
Or Mike Tyson's gonna fight Jake Paul. I don't know the rules. I don't know what's it. What do you guys think of that fight?
That's the thing I was like,
yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know if that's true.
That's
some...
I
okay.
I don't know if it's 16 ounces. I don't know if it's too many rounds.
I don't know anything.
And it's hard to say, you know, because violent crime hits us all, and Tyson's at his much, much later career. You know, it's like, can his heart keep that pace? Can his heart throw hard like that for 3 minutes or 2 minutes or whatever it is, you know? So obviously my heart is with Tyson, but I don't know what Tyson will get him, you know? Because this is a much older Tyson, you know?
What do you think?
Well, he needs a good paycheck for Mike Tyson, and he's the servant.
It's not pay-per-view, it's on Netflix.
You know what I'm saying? He's a brand. He's taking away everything he can from boxing, and hey, I don't blame him. He deserves everything. Every penny. Every penny he deserves, man.
You've met him before.
Yeah,
I did. What's that like?
Cool dude, bro. Cool dude. I have a lot of wisdom to speak.
Mike's the best. So there you have a message to your fans, people who love you and support you.
All praise be to God Almighty, Jesus Christ, and for this moment. From the situation that I come from to where I'm at right now, I would just think that thanks to God for everything. I know I don't know Jack right, especially today, you know, I was out here a little while. And if I catch any of them dudes in the street, I'm I always give all the credit where it's due, you know. I know where my skills, my ability, and my perseverance comes from God Almighty.
Were you surprised that Nate walked off?
Nah, I knew he was walking off, man. I thought he was gonna walk off many other times because I felt that he can't talk, obviously. He's way out of the fucking wet paperback, so he's already fucking getting hit with the anxiety. And then he felt my heat. I don't think he wanted to get in my face today because it had been building up already, and I was getting tired of looking at his ugly ass fucking face. So it just made sense that he walked away, man, because he could feel I was already heated. The tiger was agitated, you know, I was in the cage, people were poking at me, and then they were going to let this fucker go in my cage, I don't think so. And I think he felt that he had to walk off before, you know, he felt the heat.
Okay, Jorge?
Which, is a major name. You and your fucking crew of fucking wannabes, listen to me, bro. You took a huge L. You walked out on your fucking city, bro. You didn't give him that stare down. I came all the way from Miami to fucking stare you in the eyeballs and tell you I'm gonna fucking knock you dead. And what did you do? You ran from the fucking heat. Show up June 1st. Don't make an excuse why you didn't go. Your pinky toe got bruised or none of that shit. Just make sure you show up June 1st. Not like you did today, you fucking coward.
All right, everybody, make sure you tune into the fight. FanMeo, June 1st, or watch it live at the Forum in Los Angeles. And of course, the undercard Showtime. And you have Amato fighting Sean, and it will be fireworks all night.
Pace.
Don't miss it.
Anthony Pettis.
Ellie Sekbak reporting. So first of all, one of the best coaches of boxing, Jorge Capetillo. How you feeling, coach?
How you doing, Ellie?
We're here backstage. Jorge Masvidal. Yes. Second time you came out to the press conference with the flag. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I represent Mexico. You know what I'm saying? Here we are.
So tell me about the undercard. Chris Avila and Showtime. Showtime beat Roy Jones.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Legendary.
In his pro debut. In 204 pounds in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Yes, sir. You know, people told me about that fight, and obviously we didn't beat the man, but we beat the name. You know what I'm saying? So, and now for this new opponent, I mean, Pettis, he's been working with me almost 3 years. I got nothing but, man, he's a top athlete, he's a top man. And
it's a great fight.
It's a great fight.
Amado Vargas, Sean Garcia.
Obviously, you know, I'm with the Vargas all day. We've been together since the amateurs, and I'm still helping his dad. And I know he's gonna come up victorious as well.
What makes Jorge Masvidal good as a boxer?
His passion. Boxing was his first love. And then he did one fight in boxing, like 20 years ago, champ.
16. Or who does he fight like? Does he fight like Mayweather, like Pacquiao, like who does he fight like style?
No, he's fighting in the Mexican style, Ellie. Please.
So he fights like Canelo or Pitbull.
No. Listen. He loves Roberto Duran. We all know Roberto Duran, one of the best ever.
He gave him the belt the first time, right?
Yes, sir.
I remember.
So, we take in here and there styles for his best. And he's developing very well. I'm so happy with his work ethic. 6 a.m. in the park, right on the point. 1 p.m. in the gym, right on the point, following the program. So I'm so happy, man. I'm so happy. And I know it's going to be a great performance. And I know we're going to come up victorious. And we're preparing for 10 rounds. But don't sleep. Miami soon.
What do you think about Jorge? About Capetillo?
He's amazing, man.
Why?
Thank you. Since
we met.
I'm Ellie Sekbak, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekbak, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekbak, reporting.